They say overlanding is about the journey, and I would agree with that. This weekend's adventure would focus on that journey, and we would experience places in the Ozark National Forest that I hadn't seen in years, and the rest of the group had never seen. On this adventure, we found amazing scenery, beautiful turquoise and emerald green Ozark streams, and 16 water crossings. But this weekend wasn't just about the journey. The best thing about overlanding for me is the deep friendships that I've made. It's hard to imagine that I've known most of these guys for less than a year. But through our adventures, I've been blessed with not only great friends, but a group of guys that I call family. Spending as much time as I have in the Ozarks, I typically know what to expect on weekends like this. But sometimes, I'm surprised just how special a weekend turns out to be. This is the journey of what we have come to call the Cold Water Run. What's up, everyone? I'm Matt with Ozark Overland Adventures. For the first time since Labor Day weekend of 2020, I am heading to the Ozarks to actually camp and wheel with my friends. The last time I spent the night in the Ozarks was when I was doing the Ozark Overland Adventure Trail. I made day trips to the Ozarks, but I haven't been here overnight since Labor Day. That's horrible. I actually got Nathan behind me, Robert and John and James and Nick and Ryan are all joining us this weekend. Actually, they may already be at camp, but Nathan and I are trying to get there before dark. And it's raining, and it's gonna rain a lot tomorrow, but we don't care because it's gonna be awesome even in the wet. We've got a fun route planned tomorrow covering some areas that I haven't been to in years. So I'm anxious to see what they're like. Should have some good water crossings. Should have some good mud holes. May or may not have a few opportunities to hand out the soft shackle of shame this weekend. But I'm excited. We're gonna have a great weekend. Thanks for joining along. Here we go. What's up?
Hey.
How are y'all?
All right.
Nice spot, huh?
Very nice.
Well, we made it to camp. It's still drizzling, sprinkling, just otherwise yuck. They've got all their awnings set up. Almost set up right over here between these two trees. And it should be good.
And they've got carabiners to secure that tube.
That's
so that's
good.
Not coming
yeah,
out.
Yeah, so it just didn't fall off.
Yeah. I'm having fajitas. Nathan, what's for dinner?
Steak.
Yep. I'll have it going on.
What do they got? Some steak and rice?
Yeah. We're going to make some steak tacos and some rice.
Nice. Y'all having what they're having?
We are.
Yes.
They made it. Good boy. That's a nice one.
Oh yeah.
Little herb butter.
Yes, sir.
We don't play around when it comes to camp food. All right, I'm really, really, really happy with this moonshade. This is just perfect. About to cook dinner. Got my inflatable lantern up there. I like it.
Yeah, the March Madness run last year, we had the fire under my
Is that why it's all got holes in it now?
Probably.
Right.
And she's in the hospital, but we're doing everything we can. And Mary Catherine told the lady, she's like, well, this is how I go.
Smokehouse barbecue bacon is amazing. All right, we're about to roll out. James just brought us the magnets that he made for the soft shackle of shame. So if anybody has to be recovered today,
maybe right here.
They get that.
Yeah,
it's gonna be good. I think we should maybe leave that for Roberts because he'll need it at some point probably. But that's awesome.
hit that hard and splash.
I know.
Water crossing doesn't look bad. You can go either way. I always take the right one. It's a little deeper.
so far today has been an awesome day. The trails have been great. Water crossings have been beautiful. And now we're on a trail that I haven't been on in 5 years. And the last time I was on it, it got real interesting once we got further down. So we'll see how this goes. The weather's turning out really nice. But later this afternoon, early evening, rain is supposed to come in. So we'll see how that goes. Yeah, I think we're going to have to move that. Perfect. We did get to use a soft shackle, but not in shame. Robert said that should be the soft shackle of honor. Maybe we need a new sticker. Uh-oh. Is there a bypass?
There's one right back there.
Oh yeah, right beside you. Ow. This is bypassing. It looked like a bomb went off in here. Good grief. Yeah, I'm not sure about this bypass. Well, unfortunately we hit the end of the line and we're gonna have to turn back and backtrack quite a ways. We've got actually a little section of trail that reconnects to the highway. I don't know, maybe half mile, maybe a mile down the trail. So we're gonna backtrack back to the highway, zip up the highway and come back down in that and reconnect to where we were. At least that's the plan. We're not camping here tonight, but it would be awesome if we were. Instead, we're gonna have lunch. Huh. This is different. Oh, I bet this is a great swimming hole. Definitely have to come back to this one when it's warmer and go swimming. Maybe just stay here for a weekend. But there are some amazing amazing campsites on the stream that I definitely want to come back to and have marked. There's another one. But just a reminder, if you want to do these routes that we do and come to these campsites that that we find when we're out and about, that's what our Patreon account was for. If you want to support us and help us fulfill the dream of doing this full time and continuing to make hopefully even better videos by then, take a look at our Patreon page and consider becoming a patron of us. We would really appreciate it. And hopefully there's something in it for you.
Decided to make a little detour to show everyone something really cool. This is a really cool little cave thing. I was hoping to get the drone down in there, but I don't know if I can. Be careful, it's slick. Alternate way in. Let's see how this goes.
Somehow or another, it's affiliated with Expedition Overland. I'm not really sure how. All of their pictures are Expedition Overland pictures. Thank you.
darker out there.
This gets super sketch up here. You got a little PTSD going right now?
I don't like that at all.
Matt, it was nice knowing you. You've been a really good trail guide, but you're probably going to fall off the cliff right here, so.
Your sacrifice won't be for nothing. We'll know to turn around after you fall into the river.
We'll show the video at your funeral. Yeah, John and I are gonna have some trouble there.
Think so?
Yeah.
Huh. Just a hair. There you go. Right there, come straight. You're good, you got 2 feet over there.
You good? You can cut a little passenger.
Yeah, you're good.
You got room.
Stayed straight. Now cut. Now cut. You're good. Yeah.
That earth is Whoop. Moving right there.
Whoop it.
There you go.
Got a piece of my seat missing.
I bet.
Hold that line. Yep. Keep coming. Just come straight. Now cut. Hold that. Hold that. Hold that. Now cut. There you go. Got it. That way. All right, now cut. One more. There you go.
back.
Alright, now we're rock crawling.
Maybe.
Come on, ZR2. Yeah! Nice! For the record, they stacked rocks after I went through. The horn doesn't help.
Just pull cable and get him up. Where's the switch controller?
Stay passenger. There you go. Now come straight. You probably should have printed more soft shackles with Shane. I mean, we're at 3 now.
The ZR2 is going to be the only one that makes it up.
Yep. You act like you're surprised. I wasn't surprised.
The wheelbase and the rock stacking.
Yeah,
yeah. Wheelbase and rock stacking.
That's what you said about Kipsy Gulch, too.
I mean, that was all wheelbase, and you know it. That's your advantage.
Uh-huh.
There we go.
Woo!
Woohoo! Yep, got it. Oh, that was something. 3 out of 4 made it. We only have 3 soft shackles of shame magnets, so I guess we'll have to rock, paper, scissors or something who gets to wear them. But everybody that made it did have rocks stacked for them after I was done. So just gonna throw that out there. Well, that was the second steepest hill that I've ever found in the Ozarks. If it had a few more rock ledges, it would tie for number 1. But I think it's probably number 2. Fog settling in. Stay left. Stay left. Home sweet home.
I'm gonna go right over here.
Where are we gonna set up the big canopy at?
Here's a quick tour of our camp setup since it's gonna rain and more rain's coming. Got my moonshade here. We've got James's 230-180. And then the two canopies next to each other. Now we can have a fire, cook dinner, hang out together.
I'm just here for the dinner part.
It's gonna be real nice.
What are you cooking, Matt?
I'm cooking bread. What are you cooking?
I'm cooking spaghetti.
I think they'll go well together.
Yeah, that's a great combination.
Has anybody ever thought of that before?
Garlic bread and spaghetti?
I don't think so.
I think we just started something new.
Tonight's dinner.
But I have a lot of pitting on the front.
Spaghetti. Nathan's about to drop the noodles. And then we have homemade garlic bread. Mm.
It's a toy.
Everybody's so quiet because there's stuff in their face.
Mm-hmm. I said, oh Lord, there's a fire. Ain't nobody got time for that.
Now that's a fire.
That's hot.
I know, it's a real hot fire.
Can't get any closer than that.
Someone asked me the other day, can you build a big fire in one of those fire pits? I think the answer is yes.
Yep, that's pretty nice. Fair enough.
Well, I got those guys too on there.
Which one did she?
It's so good. Dry. Smith, what's the name?
Smith and Wesson.
It's 7 a.m. And I'm warm and cozy and don't want to get up. And I'm comfortable. Real quick, while I'm avoiding getting up. If you watched my last video on the new gear that I'm excited to use in 2021, several things that you've seen so far on this trip were in that video. This Crua, look, there's the logo. This Crua Koala Max hammock kit. Absolutely awesome. Best hammock I've ever slept in. The underquilt is great. Kept my backside from getting cold. The hammock itself, super comfortable. I don't know if it's just a little bit wider or a little bit longer or what, but it's fantastic. The little pockets that are in it, fantastic. The Rainfly, also fantastic, a little bit bigger than my last Rainfly. It's been sprinkling off and on, and you know, it's been a wet weekend. Normally there'd be condensation on the inside of the Rainfly. Not this weekend, not with this one. I don't know if it's a better material or what, but it's awesome. And this Enlightened Equipment sleeping bag quilt thing, oh my gosh. This is the best sleeping bag I've ever had. It is so warm and cozy. And just so comfortable. I've had some good sleeping bags, but I've never had one this nice. I now understand the difference between a $100 sleeping bag and a $300 sleeping bag. It's worth it. If you don't believe me, try it. And then the moonshade. The fact that it's been raining off and on, and I don't have a roof rack or an awning like mounted to my Jeep, the moonshade has been a game changer for camp and cooking and all that stuff. So anyway, my eyes watering. I'm not crying. I'm not that, you know, emotionally moved by the moonshade, but it is pretty awesome. And if you want to check out any of this stuff, there's links in the description to the Amazon store and affiliate links to websites, so you can check them out. Okay, I'm up. It's just way too beautiful here to just lay in bed all day, even though it was warm and cozy. We got James grinding his coffee for the morning. Gotta have his coffee. Let's see, there's my cozy little home over there. Nathan's finally cleaning dinner from last night. Nothing like cleaning up dinner at breakfast. There's Robert's cozy home over there. This is one of my favorite camps in all the Ozarks. We're loaded up and heading out from camp. We've got, I think, 6 water crossings today, and then we're done. This has been a great weekend. I'm excited about the rest of this day.
What's going on, Matt?
Oh, the things we do for these videos.
What's up, Robert?
Not much.
Hey, I think you need to go that way.
Nathan parked a half mile away.
Thank you.
Somebody will hook up my wing.
A little momentum.
We might make it.
Oh! Woo! Yeah!
Woo-hoo!
Yeah!
All right, we have made it off the trail and we are about to air back up and head back home. A couple of these guys gotta go to Missouri and a few gotta go to Mississippi. I think a couple of us get to stay in Arkansas. So we've had a blast overlanding this weekend, off-roading this weekend. We don't care what you call it. We had a blast doing it. And for the record, those of you with a soft shackle of shame, I did. Come on.
I did.
Come on.
Right here.
One.
On me.
James, there you go. Come
who
on.
Didn't get one this time?
Who didn't? All right, we did have Jeep, Toyota, and Chevy represented. No soft shackles of shame. So it's been a great weekend. Thanks so much for joining along with us. You know, the YouTube stuff, like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Anyway, appreciate it. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.